Welcome to Sorosar classes. Today the tutorial will be on microeconomics. And here we will talk about well-behaved preference in this particular tutorial. In case of any queries or doubt, you can contact us on this particular number. And our website, email website is www.sorosarclasses.com. Now before starting, I should tell you what do you mean by well-behaved preferences. Now, any preferences that satisfy the two criteria, that is monotonicity and convexity, will be termed as well-behaved preference. To keep the video short, monotonicity in short actually implies that ICs will be negatively sloped, whereas convexity means that convex combination will be preferred rather than extremes. Moving on. Now, in the first question of well-behaved preference, let me read to you. Alicia likes watching DVDs, which is X1, and listen to her favorite CD, that is X2. Her utility function is provided to us and we need to find the MRS. Now, before we start the question number A, there is a hint given to us, that is, or a trick we will say rather. We are asked to take the logarithmic transformation, log transformation of the utility function. Now, why it is so? When we take log transformation, that means the utility function will definitely change, but such kind of transformation is termed as monotonic transformation. Now, if there is one utility function and we are changing it to another, taking a log transformation, don't you think so that the answer will change? Now, we don't know about the answer, but here we need to find out the marginal rate of substitution, which will definitely not change because the order of preferences will be preserved or are preserved whenever we undertake monotonic transformation. So we start with the utility function this, we take a log transformation as provided, as the trick is provided in the question itself, and we take the log transformation, so it will be this function. Now we'll find out the partial derivatives. Now the partial derivatives mu1 will be 3x1 and the other one will be 1 by x2. Now we need to, so even if the utility function are not same, this must be kept in mind, the MRS will be same because under monotonic transformation we actually preserve the order of preferences. This is very important. Now we will look on MRS, that is the marginal rate of substitution. This is the formula. So let us substitute the values. So we get 3 by x1 divided by 1 by x2. And this is nothing but minus 3x2 by x1. So this will be the answer. Okay. And this particular value is also the slope of the IC. Is also the slope of the IC passing through that point. Okay, so if they ask you instead of MRS to find out the slope, the answer would have been the same. Okay, moving on. Now we move on to the part B of the same question. In this particular question, we are asked to find the individual or plot the individual IC, okay, that passes through the bundle 1, 1. So our coordinate is 1, 1. So let us mark here DVDs I have taken on the horizontal axis and CDs on the vertical axis. So let us write 1, 1. This coordinate is already provided. And let us make a tangent. Okay. So I'll make the tangent. Let me change the color. So, okay. So this is our tangent. Okay. And the slope of this, and the slope, this is the tangent, and the slope of this IC is minus 3. That is the marginal rate of substitution. The how we are getting it? We are getting it using this formula. MRS is given by this. We have already derived this in the previous part. Now at 1, 1, we will substitute the value of x2 and x1 where both are 1. So it is this. So it is minus 3. So the slope of IC is minus 3. Okay. And these are the coordinates which has already been provided in the question. Now the next first is find the MRS for the bundle, okay, and depict it on the graph. Both has been done. Which good is locally more valued at 1, 1, DVD or CD? Now let us see. At 1, 1, good one DVD is more valued. Why? Because, and you can see this answer we will get from the marginal rate of substitution itself, minus 3. Because since 3 units of CDs has to be given up for 1 unit of DVD. So 3 CDs you are exchanging for 1 unit of DVD. So definitely DVD is more valuable. So the more locally more valuable good is DVD. Okay. Now, and definitely you have to mention it is not always, it is only at 1, 1. Okay. Next we move on to part C. Here it is said that the price of a DVD is $40 and the price of the CD is $20, and the income of Alicia is given to be is $800. Okay. So we need to write down the two conditions that guarantee the optimality of our choice. Okay, so let's see what are the two conditions. Now the two conditions are exhaustion of the budget. So this implies numerically or in algebraic, or if you want to write it in notation form, this simply means that P1X1, that is price of one commodity into the quantity consumed of other commodity. P2X2, this is the price of the second commodity, amount of quantity consumed of the second commodity, should be equal to the income. Okay. So this actually means, because we have been provided with all the values, so we can write that 40X1 plus 20X2 is equal to 800. Okay. Now, the second says that the slope of IC is equal to slope of budget line. Now we know slope of IC, we have already derived it to be minus 3x2 by x1, which is equal to slope of budget line. So what is the slope of budget line? It is nothing but minus P1 by P2. Let us write the two prices, that is minus 40 by 20. So this comes to 2. So ultimately we get minus 3x2 by x1 is equal to minus 2. Okay. Now, or we can say x2 is equal to 2x1 by 3. Fair enough. So now let us draw the budget line as well as the IC. So this is our budget line. The two intercept will be 40 and 20. which we get using the formula m by p2, which is 40. Or if you don't want to remember the formula, it is very easy. You take this particular equation with all the values written. Now you consider, if you want to calculate the intercept of x2, take x1 to be 0. If x1 is 0, then x2 will be 800 by 20 and you will get 40. Similarly, for horizontal intercept, you assume x2 to be 0. So x1 will be 800 by 40 and you will get 20. And this is nothing but m by p1. Okay, now we will draw the IC.